everybody. Pastor Chris here. Listen, I just want to take a couple minutes of your time to address the COVID-19 one more time. And this is where it's birthed out of. This morning, I went to Costco to go get some products for the church. And somebody said if you get there at their opening, that they'll have stuff. Well, they did not. It was everything sold out. And so on my way home, empty-handed, I thought, you know what? I'm going to do something different. I'm going to, instead of listen to worship music, and I'm going to listen to the news. I want to hear what the world's saying about all this. And let me just preface by saying, I don't think there's anything wrong with listening to the news. But I do want to make sure that as you're listening, that what you're putting into your head and into your heart is not overtaking the seat of authority, which should be Jesus Christ. In that 15-minute drive, as I was listening to all the stuff that's going on in the news, one of the things that my father said to me came really, really true. He told me yesterday, he said, Chris, it's a good thing you didn't end up in Israel this week, because the whole wide world has gone crazy. And as I'm listening to the news, that's what it sounds like. The hysteria over this virus has gone crazy. It has reached pandemic level, so I don't think we should ignore that. But the danger and the caution that I have for you as your pastor is to make sure that your spirit does not hit pandemic level. That to remember that in 2 Timothy, scripture says God did not give you a spirit of fear, but he gave you power. It's dunamis power, the same power that raised Jesus from the grave lives in you. He gives you love. That's agape love, unconditional love, that unearned, undeserved love. And he gives you what? A sound mind. He did not give you the spirit of fear. He gave the spirit of power and of love and a sound mind. So let's keep things in perspective. And here's what I want to say to you. There's a difference in being prepared and being scared. There's a difference in being prepared and being scared. When you allow all of this stuff to fester inside of you, it will breed fear. And what I'm finding is that when I talk to people, because we have people coming through the church all day long, and as I'm talking to people, they're saying, you know, I'm not really afraid of the virus. I'm afraid of, well, I don't know what I'm afraid of. It's messing up my schedule. It's messing up our summer. It's messing up our trips. I've got this investment. I got that going. And that's what most fear is. It's fear of the unknown. And when you are afraid of what you don't know, that is the opposite of faith. Faith is being certain of what you do not know. And what I am certain of is the things that God tells me about myself. And that, my friends, has been the core message for these past several weeks that we've been preaching on. When I talked about favor, when I talked about loving the Lord God with all your heart, when I talked about loving the Lord your God with all your soul, and certainly when I talked about loving the Lord your God with all your mind, all of it is predicated on our faith in God, our faith in finding favor in the fight, and seeing God in the follow through. And so I want to just encourage you that it's okay to be prepared. You should wipe things down and stay good hygiene and do all those things. But don't allow yourself to be scared. Don't allow the enemy to cripple you. Now, I do want to say this. Part of preparedness is using your brain intelligently. And if you are somebody who's perhaps elderly, or you've got a pre-existing condition, or you've got some respiratory issues, or maybe you're sick, let me tell you, it's okay for you to not come to church on Sunday. We will broadcast all of our services online. You're going to be a part of those water baptism services Sunday. It's going to be awesome. And we have, you can give you online. You can go right into, there's a whole giving tab. You can check all that out. www.cornerstoneCT.org. You can download our app. All our app will inform you. If you allow the notifications, it'll tell you when we're going live. And as we're progressing through this process together, we as a church will be more and more prepared to make sure that the gospel message does not get squashed squelched in the hysteria of this virus. We're going to get through this because greater is he that is in us than he that is in this world. So I want you to be encouraged and be of good cheer and know that the favor of God is with you today. He's given you power and love and a sound mind. God bless you. I hope to see you Sunday. Be well, praying for you all. God bless. Bye-bye.